Hi everyone, today our topic is how to do parameterization in Apache JMeter tool. You can see this is only our topic, how to do parameterization in Apache JMeter tool. This is our topic. Okay, first of all I need to open my JMeter, go to E folder and Apache JMeter 5.4.1, go to bin folder, you need to open the JMeter. Just a minute, is to open that one. Yeah, it's loading. Yeah, this is the JMeter. Okay, you need to do the parameterization. You need to create any one small script. Okay, I will create one small script. In test plan, right click, add the thread group. Under thread group, go to logic controller and go to recording controller. Under thread group, you need to add the any one listener. And go to test plan and right click, go to non-test element, select the HTTPS test script recorder. Okay, I will give the port number is 8080 by default. I will select the target controller is test plan thread group recording controller. All the requests will be recorded in recording controller only. And request filtering, you need to select add, suggested, explore. Okay, this side everything is done. Now you need to go to the, I will select to the Internet Explorer. Application name is JPET Store. Okay, you can go to the Internet options, connections, LAN settings. You need to select the use process server. Okay, localhost 8080. Localhost means it's my computer only. That reason I will provide the localhost. Your point of view, any company you need to use now, you can provide the that machine IP address or host name you need to provide. Port you need to provide. By default, I will take 8080. Okay, once the configure will be done, just you need to click on enter. Is showing the process server is not responding. Okay, it's a write you need to process setup. Go to JMeter, everything you already set up, just click on start. It's not required, so is leaving automatically. Okay, can leave it this side. Go to the application, just click on enter. Application is open now. I will click on the sign in. I will type the username J2E username and password also J2E. Okay, that is by default username and password. Click on login. Login page is once is loaded, after you need to click on the sign out. Okay guys, it's a recording is done. Okay, this is only flow I will take in. Let's stop. Now you need to go to JMeter, expand. You can see the request, everything will recorded only JPET store only. You can see PET store. Pet store, pet store, pet store, pet store, and everything is pet store. After, you can go to the in E folder. I am already created the in test data. You can see username and password means username comma password. by default will provide the pet store username and password j2ee comma j2ee after j2ee 1 comma j2ee 1 1 2 2 3 3 I will provide it, this type of one. How we need to parameterize now? First of all, you need to right click the thread group, go to config element. This is the first one, CSV dataset config. And the CSV dataset config, go to the under the thread group. Okay. Okay, you need to copy this username password. This is important. You can close it. First of all, you need to browse and you need to take the path that location. Then go to PC, E drive. There is a username, the text file only, and variable delimiter. Okay. Okay, this is the mainly parameterization section in JMeter tool. Name is called CSV dataset config. Okay. CSV means comma separated value dataset config. You will provide the test data under the test. Okay. First of all is the file name. File name means you need to browse the where is the available your text file or CSV file or Excel sheet. That all the files you need to browse and you need to provide the document, test data document path. File encoding means it's the different types of formats. UTF-8, UTF-16. Okay, majorly you can use for UTF-8 only. It's a universal format. And variable names means it's a comma delimiter, na, username, comma password. The variable names means this one. Where is that one? Under your test data, you will provide this is the variable names. Username, comma password. Na, the top of the highlight one, this is the variable names. You need to provide these variable names. After, ignore first line, only used if variable name is not empty. Okay, ignore first line. You can provide the ignore first line. Na? Here you can select, this is important point, ignore first line. Only used if variable name is not empty. Ignore first line means you need to provide the true. Okay. Why means? This is the variable names. Now first line, you need to, this row, first row or first line, this one you need to leave it. Remaining test data you need to take. You need to provide that type of instruction. That reason only you need to select the true. Ignore first line, that is true. After, after delimiter, you need to provide the comma only. Allow quoted data, you need to select false only. The main allow quoted data means this one's simple concept only, but it's a different one. I will explain after. Recycle and end of file. You need to true, you need to provide. Once the test data is completed under the test, you need to reuse the test data. Stop thread on end of file. Okay, once test is stopped, test data is completed, you need to stop. You need to select the false. Na? Once the test data is completed also, you can reuse the test data and you're moving the test. And sharing modes. Sharing modes means, example, there is only one thread. Okay, there is only one thread. You have multiple threads now. You will provide the test data. All the threads will be used to the your test data. All threads. Or current thread group. Current thread group means, example, this is a one thread group. Under thread group, you need to create any another threads. The test data will be used only the specific thread, and child threads only will be used. No, not using for the different type of threads. current thread means this one. Example, this is only one thread only, na? You will provide the test data, this thread only will be used. Edit is, you need to edit that one. Okay, what are the things you require? You need to write the some custom code and you need to provide the test data, external side. And alloquated data. Alloquated data means it's a very simple example. Example, my I will provide this one. Okay, example, this is my name. Allowed quoted data means it's a double quotations you need to provide, but you have a some space. Okay, that time that one what will be do na in allowed quoted data, this Gauri Shankar, this not only one name, he will consider the two names. Gauri is different and Shankar will be different. Okay, that time you need to solve that type of issues na, the space will become na, it will show some error will be came. That time you need to close that one. You no need to take any space, that type of things. You need to close all the space and you need to provide the double quotations. That type only this one will be considered the one name or word, that type of format will be taken. Okay, this all the things will become issues in test data point of view only. That reason only you selected all your quarter data is false only will select. Okay, these are the main things. Okay, now it's a parameterization is done, just you need to replace that one. You can go to location, this is the username. Okay, you can provide the dollar, open and close flower brackets, and you need to provide the username and go to test data. Take the password. Dollar open close. Okay, this is also username password. It's done. This name is this is the parameterization. In under E drive only will save everything. Okay, this is the test data. I am already parameterization also will be done. This is the way you need to provide dollar open and close square brackets within the name, within the place you need to provide the username and password. Okay, first of all you need to check it's able to properly working or not. Yeah, it's able to work everything. Okay, now you need to run to the just. Four users and ramp up is only 2 seconds and I will select the infinity and the time is only 1 minute, means 60 seconds I will provide it. And I need to run and you need to validate that one, it's able to work or not properly. Okay, just you can hold on, it's running for the test. Okay, you need to set up any test data, anything for testing purpose before starting any test. Okay, just you need to run for 2-3 minutes or 5-6 minutes, you need to run the test. That means the test data is able to properly is working or not, you need to check. Not only from JMeter, for any tool. Okay. You can see it's already time is gone. Okay. Just 10 seconds will complete the test. Yeah, it's completed. Just you need to go and check it one time. You can go to request. You can moving now. Automatically will came. You can see username J2EE3. Password J2EE3. Okay, remaining also same wave only will be working. Okay, this is the way guys you need to do parameterization. The parameterization element is CSV dataset config file. Okay, you need to remember. Yeah, that's all guys, this video. Yeah, our topic is completed. How to do parameterization in Apache JMeter tool. Thanks for everyone. I will connect to my next video. Bye.